Hey everyone, Dr. Zio here again, and today we're here to talk about Power Rangers Cosmic Fury. Now, in light of the copious amount of drama we've had surrounding Power Rangers Cosmic Fury, Hasbro's marketing or lack thereof for the show, as well as the recent news that Power Rangers is leaving New Zealand, so Cosmic Fury will be the last season filmed in New Zealand, which is sad. Yeah, that really sucks. And you know, Hasbro hasn't really done much marketing for the season, which we covered this back in Once and Always, but I do want to say just one thing here real quick. Again, there's nothing wrong with this. The only thing wrong is that the toys are just appearing on the shelves without any sort of fanfare from Hasbro themselves. That's abnormal. Normally we would see this toys at Toy Fair or some sort of expo, get a look at them, a good look at them beforehand, and then we would get them on store shelves. The fact that none of that has happened and they just appeared on store shelves, that is a cause for concern. But the fact that Hasbro hasn't dropped any, press photos or any trailers, clips, any of that beyond the suit reveals and things surrounding the suits, that's normal. This is a streaming TV show. This is normal procedure for a streaming TV show. As I said before, Netflix and other streamers don't typically start marketing their shows, marketing as in doing press tours, doing posters, clips, trailers, until at least around 1 to 2 months before the release date. Us being Power Rangers fans, we're not used to that. We're used to marketing starting up at least in some way, shape, or form before that. But again, this is all new territory for us. We need to adjust because this is the way it's going to be going forward, whether we continue with the current continuity or we jump into the Entwistle stuff after this season or maybe even after a gap year next year. This is the new normal going forward, and there's nothing really wrong with it. You can't expect Hasbro to do marketing right now because that's not how it works in today's day and age. You want to be a modern TV show? This is what modern TV shows do. Just like we just got marketing started up for Harley Quinn and the new season of Futurama on Hulu, those fans have been in the dark for those series until now, a month before their respective release. At the time of this recording, Harley Quinn still doesn't have a trailer for season 4. Those fans are still waiting on a trailer for their fourth season. And I've seen people say that, well, why not just drop clips of Cosmic Fury? Because that's not happening. Show me shows that we know have an upcoming season that have dropped clips before the rest of the marketing is supposed to have started. Like, it's not a thing outside of like those big festivals, then you might get clips at those festivals or big events like Netflix's, was it Tudum Dare and things like that, or yeah. But yeah, this is the way it's going to be going forward. I just wanted to say that real quick. Another thing I want to say is that we're going to be talking about in this video my predictions for Power Rangers Cosmic Fury based on the rumors, screenshots, social media posts, all that kind of stuff we've gathered up here since I started doing my monthly update since October. Now, in doing that, there is one thing I do want to go over. There is the elephant in the room of Ollie going evil or joining Lord Zedd somewhere in Cosmic Fury's run. That article was posted by the Luminarity a few months ago. I have not read that article in full, nor will I do that for this video. The most I'm discussing is what you're going to see in like those first few, two, three sentences. And that is the fact that Ollie is rumored to be joining Lord Zedd in Cosmic Fury. That's all I'm discussing. And if I see any discussion beyond that in the comments, your comment will be deleted. That's too big of going into spoiler territory for me. And I don't want to have such a big, important plot detail like that spoiled for myself or my viewers in any capacity beyond what we're going to be talking about here today. So with all that said, let's go ahead and jump right into it and talk about where I think Power Rangers Cosmic Fury will go during its 10-episode run as it debuts exclusively on Netflix later on this fall. So, episode 1, the premiere. So, we already know from Simon Bennett's tweets in the past that Cosmic Fury picks up right where Dino Fury left off. And as we know from Dino Fury, Zeta has been revived by the Morphin Masters to deal with Lord Zedd because somehow Lord Zedd escaped. So Zeta's got a new form, dubbed behind the scenes as the Ghost Ranger, and he's gathering up the Rangers. They teleport off and then cut to black. So we're going to fade back in. The Rangers are going to be doing whatever they're doing, wherever they teleported to. I think that we might get, for the majority of the episode, the Rangers looking for Lord Zedd and Zeta, catching everyone up with what he's been doing, what the Morphin Masters have been up to. And then we'll get the actual confrontation with Lord Zedd. Now, there were photos posted sometime late last year, I think it was October or November, by the production crew, showcasing that we're going to go back to the very familiar Corey that we saw at Megaforce's Legendary Battle. I'll post it here somewhere in this general area. But one thing to note, there's, I think that's going to play a big part in the premiere. I think that at this point, that's going to be the site for the big battle. That's where Lord Zedd and the Rangers will come face to face. You're going to have your six Cosmic Fury, or six Dino Fury Rangers with their Dino Fury Ranger powers, along with Zedo's Ghost Ranger powers, versus Lord Zedd with his staff in full power, maybe Scrozzle, and whatever new minions and generals that Lord Zedd has managed to scrounge up in a time since we last saw him. That battle is going to go south very, very fast, because we know from Dino Fury that the Rangers don't stand a chance against Lord Zedd. The only questionable factor here is Zeta with his Ghost Ranger powers. That was directly bestowed upon him by the Morphin Masters. And we know that Master Green specifically made the Dino Master Saber back in Dino Fury Season 2 so that it could be used to deal with Lord Zedd. Of course, Zeta had to use it to deal with Void Queen's Nemesis Beast, and that didn't really go as planned either, but I'm going to chalk that one up to the sword not being built specifically for that use case. We're going to assume for the purpose of this video that that sword would have been strong enough to deal with Lord Zedd himself. So, going off that, and the Morphin Masters bestowing Zeta with his Ghost Ranger powers, I'm going to assume that Zeta is at least strong enough to take on Lord Zedd, but maybe not strong enough to take on Lord Zedd plus his new cronies. And so, because of that, we already know the Dino Fury Rangers themselves, with their Dino Fury powers, aren't strong enough to go up toe-to-toe with Lord Zedd. Lord Zedd stomped them very, very easily the last time we saw him on screen. In fact, he almost stomped Master Green and almost killed her if it wasn't for Ion interjecting with his, Dino Master Mode powers. So, going off of that, we're going to assume that the Rangers suffer a crushing defeat, and maybe at some point, Javi uses the shield block Dino Key to block one of Lord Zedd's staff blows, and in doing so, the arm that he used the shield block key with, it doesn't fully block the hit, it breaks the shield and severely injures his arm. Now, battered and bruised, and understanding that they can't use their current power set to stop Lord Zedd and his cronies, the Rangers are going to teleport away, or maybe the Morphin Masters teleport the Rangers away, and they go back to Dinohenge. At this point, the Rangers say their goodbyes to everyone else, and that's where we end episode 1. Well, we'll end episode 1 with the Rangers going back to Dinohenge. Episode 2 will open with the Rangers trying to recover from their recent defeat. Javi maybe has his arm in a sling, and the Rangers are trying to, figure out where do we go from here. At that point, the Morphin Masters will come down from the above, or come from the Morphin Grid, to bestow upon them the Cosmic Fury powers. Now that they have the Cosmic Fury powers, they're all on an equal playing ground, and they know that they can now go toe-to-toe with Lord Zedd and his cronies. So, it's at this point that the Rangers say their goodbyes to their family, Izzy to Fern, everyone that they know here on Earth, and Pearl Harbor, so that they can go into space, and then without anything really holding them back, per se. Because they also don't know if this is going to be their final journey. They don't know if they're going to come back alive. So, at this point, the Rangers jettison off into space to go fight Lord Zedd. Now, somewhere along the runtime of episode 2, their mission is going to be finding where Lord Zedd is stationed so they can take the battle to him directly. In the meantime, while they're going off into space, they'll run into none other than Billy Cranston, the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Blue Ranger, who we last saw in Once and Always earlier this year. Now, Once and Always taught us that Billy's back from space. He's got his own Cranston Technologies, and below Cranston Technologies, he's built up his own, he's built up a new command center that the Rangers can operate out of. Now, I say all that to kind of remind you of the events of Once and Always, Billy, you know, trying to bring back Zordon, mostly because I want to point out that Simon Bennett did state that Once and Always, or the story beats for Cosmic Fury, were done before Once and Always was a thing. So, we can assume that in the process of Once and Always resetting Billy and, you know, setting him up to go back into space, the events of Once and Always will not be a big factor or a factor at all within Cosmic Fury's runtime of those 10 episodes. We won't get him referencing Min. We won't get him referencing, you know, the, you know, Rita situation. We won't get Billy referencing the fact that he tried to bring back Zordon and utterly failed miserably. But we will probably get him talking about, you know, how he can help the Rangers because he knows Ranger technology. I think at this point, he'll either analyze the Rangers' Cosmic Fury powers and then build them the new Cosmic Fury Zords himself, or he'll work with Javi, or not Javi, but Ollie, to build those Zords, or Ollie and Solon to build the Zords. Maybe even working with Ollie, Solon, and Izzy, because we know that all three of those individuals have some technical know-how, so it makes sense that they would be able to help him with building Zords, or at least they would be able to learn something from Billy to build those Zords. Now, how Billy would factor into the rest of the season, I'm not too sure of yet. I haven't really gotten a good theory on that yet, beyond I think that Billy will feel some sort of responsibility to help the Rangers defeat Lord Zedd, because that is one of his old villains, and the Mighty Morphin Rangers never properly beat Lord Zedd or Rita. So I think this will be a nice little cathartic moment for him to join the fight in some way, shape, or form, and, you know, help the Rangers beat Lord Zedd once and for all. Now, at this point, I think that this is where the Rangers are going to split off into three different groups. So we have group number one, which is the core Rangers. We have Amelia, Javi, Izzy, and then Ion. So four Rangers right now. Episode 3 is where Fern is going to join the team as the Orange Ranger. Now, how exactly they get her to join the team if the Rangers are off in space, I'm not sure. Maybe the Morphin Masters pop back into Pine Ridge and they're like, hey, you know, the Rangers need help. I know that you want to see Izzy again, so let's go ahead and get you into some suits and we'll teleport you to where they are. Obviously, I also think that Izzy is not going to be exactly too happy about this, because your first Ranger assignment going up against Lord Zedd is, that's a bad idea. That is sending off a lot of red flags. But I think that Fern is going to round off the Ranger team with maybe Billy helping in with his Mighty Morphin Power Rangers every so often. Meanwhile, I think that Zato, as a Zenith Ranger, is going to entrust the Red Ranger leadership ability or leadership role, so to speak, to Amelia, because I think he's had a higher calling. I think at this point, it's going to be up to Zato as a Zenith Ranger to separate from his current team and go off on his own mission. That mission being how to stop Lord Zedd once and for all, if maybe the Cosmic Fury powers don't exactly work as intended, or maybe that he wants to figure out where Lord Zedd is in general. Maybe he's doing the Andros thing and getting more intel. Or maybe he's going to be the Ryan, the Titanium Ranger, so to speak, of the season, where he separates from them to go gather more intel for that final fight. But the difference between Ryan and Zato is that Cosmic Fury has a benefit of filming all original footage. And because of that, you can have Zato communicating with the Rangers more often. We can go from the Core Rangers to Zato's mission and check in with him every so often on some random alien planet. Or we can have Zato teleport in to help the Rangers when they absolutely need the power of six Rangers instead of just five. Or six Rangers plus Billy instead of five Rangers plus Billy. I also think in the process of episode 3 or episode 4, somewhere within that time span, Lord Zedd is going to capture the three remaining Morphin Masters. I don't think his plans are necessary to destroy them, but I think he's going to capture them. Now, the reason I say this is because they need to get the Morphin Masters off the playing field in some way, shape, or form. The Morphin Masters are a deus ex machina. They're a force that can just conjure stuff up at will. It doesn't make sense for them to be there and for the Rangers not to call upon them in such a grave situation like Lord Zedd being back in the playing field. So I think Lord Zedd's purpose here will be to capture the Morphin Masters and then use their connection to the Morphin Grid to create his own army of evil Rangers. If not evil Rangers, then evil minions. As we saw Simon Bennett post on Instagram a few days ago, he did post a photo of a mysterious helmet in the middle of Beast Morpher's Red and Dino Charge Gold's helmet. Now, we know that that's not Lord Zedd. Simon's already clarified that, hey, do you think that I would really post an upgrade for Lord Zedd in a random Instagram post? That's basically all but saying that that is not Lord Zedd. But the overall design language from that helmet indicates that it is tied to Lord Zedd in some way, shape, or form. And I believe that Lord Zedd took his own design language and put that into his minions, his mooks or grunts for the season. So I think that they're going to be powered by aspects of the Morphin Grid, which is going to make them a greater threat to the Cosmic Fury Rangers going further into this season. Plus, the Morphin Masters being out of the fray gives Zato something else to do in trying to figure out where Lord Zedd's holding them, as well as trying to figure out a way to get them free. Now, that brings us to Ollie, the star of, well, one of the stars of the show. And I think Ollie, in going evil and joining Lord Zedd, I think that that's part of a greater plan that's being orchestrated by Emilia, Zato, and Ollie. I don't think that the writers would repeat story beats from Dino Fury, because we've already seen Ollie joining Lord Zedd, although he was under a spell, but repeating that general story beat doesn't seem like a good idea. We've already seen where that goes. We've seen him get the spell broken. However, if you want to flip that story beat on its head, then you make Ollie join Lord Zedd under false pretenses. Maybe Ollie tells Lord Zedd that I'm tired of having all this ranger power and not being able to do much of it because I have to adhere to the humanistic moral values of the Rangers, the Morphin Grid, the Morphin Masters, and all this other kind of stuff. And I'm tired of having all this power and not being able to fully take advantage of it. So he joins Lord Zedd's forces, but in actuality, he's just another element of the grand plan. Ollie comes in because he's trying to figure out how to defeat Lord Zedd from the inside. He's feeding intel to Emilia and Zato. He's trying to figure out where the Morphin Masters are and how to free them as well. So he is their inside man, so to speak. So we've got three different components here. We got Ollie as their inside man. Zato is the person off doing his own mission, trying to figure out where Lord Zedd is, where the Morphin Masters are being held, and how to defeat them. Zato and Ollie are basically doing the same thing with different methods to cover all their bases. Meanwhile, Emilia is leading the team in trying to defeat the Lord Zedd as a, I guess, a going at the front door kind of method. You know, the most obvious method of defeating Lord Zedd while also distracting him from what Ollie and Zato are doing on the side. Now, in all of this, I still haven't exactly figured out where Heckle was rumored to appear and what his overall goal will be. Maybe he does come in from the Dino Charge dimension to help out for some reason. Maybe Heckle that we get in Cosmic Fury is actually the Heckle of the Prime Dimension, and he has the Dark Energy powers already, and he's doing his own thing. But yeah, I'm not too sure. And this week, we also learned that General Shaw from Power Rangers Beast Morphers will be returning for Cosmic Fury in some capacity. That article posted by New Zealand Press did specify at the end that, I think Teula Blakely, I know I'm messing that first name up. I do apologize. That she will be joining Power Rangers Cosmic Fury. She'll make an appearance in Cosmic Fury. So I don't really know how she may factor into that, because again, she's a planetary ranger. Maybe she's the one who gets in contact with Billy for the Rangers, or tells them where Billy is located so they can go find him to help build the Cosmic Fury Megazords and their new fleet of Zords. But yeah, I haven't exactly figured out where things go there. But eventually, this all leads into the final battle, with the Rangers finally freeing the Morphin Masters and then having defeated Lord Zedd's generals and his minions. It's now just a fight between Lord Zedd and the Rangers themselves. That is your 7 Cosmic Fury Rangers: Ion, Izzy, Zato, Amelia, Javi, Ollie, and Fern, as well as Billy in the Mighty Morphin Blue suit. Hell, maybe he gets a new suit at some point in time, but I am not counting on that. But basically, you have your 8 Rangers. Maybe Heckle makes 9. Maybe Tarek factors in somehow, because we know that Tarek is also in the season some way, shape, or form. Maybe he's just there as in the goodbye element. But we have those Rangers going up against Lord Zedd. Bada bing, bada boom. You know, they end up defeating Lord Zedd and then go home. We also know that Mick is coming back from behind the scenes photos. We have that makeup board as well as new photos of some stunt actors in uniform. And one of them is Mick's stunt double. So we know for sure, without a doubt, that Mick is coming back. And I'm genuinely not sure what Mick would be doing with the Cosmic Fury Rangers. I mean, obviously he's going to help them in some way, but yeah, not too sure how exactly. Maybe he's the one who introduces them to Billy or something. Maybe he helps them build the Cosmic Fury Zords. Maybe it's Mick and Billy who build the Zords, because Mick has experience with, you know, building Zord technology with the Ninja Nexus Prism and the Ninja Power Stars back in Ninja Steel. But yeah, I'm not too sure about how he factors into the grand elements of things. But yeah, then we get a nice little happy ending with the Rangers saying their goodbyes and the Rangers, yeah, staying on Earth. Yeah, that's where I think that this Cosmic Fury is going to go in the 10 episode run, and I think it's still a lot. I think we are pushing a lot into those 10 episodes from the leaks that we have right now. It does somewhat worry me. Just a little bit. But at the same time, I trust Simon, Becca, Alwyn, everyone else involved with the production of the season to deliver a good product that doesn't feel too rushed or doesn't feel rushed or badly paced. So yeah, I'm still excited about Cosmic Fury. I absolutely cannot wait for the premiere this fall. Can't wait to get that first trailer. I will, of course, be avoiding that trailer. At that point, that is when we stop the monthly updates. I will talk about the trailer dropping, but I will not watch the trailer myself, because I don't want to see any clips of the season. I want to go in as blindly as I can, aside from these leaks. I know it doesn't make sense, but it makes sense for me. But yeah, let me know what y'all think about all this in the comment section below. Let me know where y'all think Cosmic Fury is going to go, what the story beats are going to be, you know, how this is all going to play out in the comment section below. If you've been watching this on YouTube, thank you for watching. If you've been listening to this on your favorite podcatcher, thank you for listening. As always, I'm Dr. Zio. Please like this video wherever you may be. Rate it, subscribe, comment if you can, because it does help with the YouTube algorithm. Until next time, again, I'm Dr. Zio. Thank you for watching and listening. I appreciate it as always, and I will see you all in the next one. I hope you have a good week. Ciao.